Lately, I've been thinking of films that defy the convention of what we think of as movies. Films that don't have a discrete, easily understandable, plot-driven narrative. Films made up of images that challenge and stupefy us. They may be challenging, but they're no less profound than the types of movies we're accustomed to. I've been thinking of a film recently. It's called Querido by a local entertainer Mystica. Much of the film is confounding. It's over 6 hours long. There's barely a plot for those who decide to take the plunge and watch the film. And as for the acting, well...
And here it is. You're saying that you and your wife are back together?
But something has been drawing me back to the film recently. Especially after having seen certain films from 2016 Cinema One Originals documentary category. When one thinks of a documentary, one usually remembers talking heads or some sort of topic or subject matter that is discussed in length in an audiovisual manner. Not here. Two of the three documentaries can hardly be classified documentaries at all, although the definition of what a documentary is can be rather nebulous. So, what about Querido? Films can be read in different ways. What about this one? In this video, The Apotheosis of Mystica, an experimental reading of Querido. One of the major things that drew me back to Querido is the level of meta within the film's framework. At times, you see the movie and behind-the-scenes footage filmed side-by-side, along with news footage and actual home videos. It soon becomes clear that the movie refuses to be defined by any one genre. Fiction and reality distort and merge as the film changes shape and tone. A cinematic chimera, if you will. It's a technique used by collage and experimental films. And here, I think it's because the movie was made to be taken as a whole. In its entirety, the film becomes personification. As opposed to simple biopics that showcase the highlights of a person's life, Querido the film is the personification of Mystica herself. Querido starts with a macho dancer gyrating to a rendition of O Fortuna, a song about fate. And this ties itself into the film's narrative of fate and destiny. The macho dancer and the spotlights in the background represent different layers of Mystica's personality, her id, ego, and superego manifesting in the frame. They also represent her character as a performer, bearing almost all, showing off on stage. The names of her talents have food names in them, signifying the primordial life force. Because, as we all know, Bopis is an important part of the daily meal. And a source of intrigue later in the story, Spicy Facebook, signifies the dangers of social media if improperly used. The scenes in the film can be segregated into body, mind, and spirit. Body manifests in the form of the numerous love scenes between Mystica and her lover, as well as her display of prowess in fighting and her resistance to poison. Mind manifests in the form of her environmental awareness, her thoughts regarding life and the manifestation of her id through the female gaze, as the object of her affection goes through a majority of his scenes with a distinct lack of clothes. Yes, even while rescuing a traffic accident victim. That and lots of macho dancing. Lots and lots of macho dancing. Also in general, Mystica's naughty side and her sense of humor.
Joshua! Lamesa ka ba?
Bakit?
Papatong naman.
Her spirit manifests during the latter half of the film, with sequences that would not feel out of place in a religious program. This and her various claims to be able to heal sick.
Pangiti na ako kasi sinabi ng doktor na OK
okay ka na, wala nang sakit, wala nang lahat.
Well, I don't need this anymore. Oh look, garbage movies.
It's easy to dismiss Querido as a bad film. You could ask why so many home movie sequences? Well, she's bearing the chronicle of her life to us. Remember Simulacrum Tremendum? It's 13 hours long and even has live piano accompaniment. And that's almost all home movies. Mostly everything else is a subjective judgment of style. The most pertinent point that can be levied against Mystica's film is that it lacks craft, a term that also defies convenient explanation. But the lack of craft in this case can be intentional, giving the film a more personal and raw character. And this sense of rawness is also seen in the way the film is presented. Mystica manages to make a film showing both her good qualities and her flaws, her weaknesses, her idiosyncrasies, her basic humanity, with Mystica being just as flawed as the film is flawed, personification mirroring the self. The film, as apotheosis, is not the transformation of art into a perfect godlike creature, but someone merely human, just like us. We see movies that entertain us, that excite us, that make us feel the simple joy of living, of loving. We see movies that make us feel emotions, or movies that make a statement. We judge movies as good or bad, but sometimes you have to look back to the movies you've seen and find diamonds in the rough. Querido ends with a recorded interview of her life. Here, she's happy and content with her friends and family, the talents that she's supported over the years. Like the film that personifies her, she's far from perfect. And you know what? That's okay.
Hello, Bane here. Thanks for watching, everyone. I tell you all to subscribe to my Patreon, if I had one. But anyway, thanks again. Oh, and happy April Fool's Day. You do know this is kind of a joke video, right? Or is it?